Well, many rational people watching this impeachment process are sort of mentally preparing for the Senate trial portion of it. Some of his supporters are preparing for what comes after, and they're getting ready for war. Take a look at this bit of video that CBS News posted of them interviewing some Trump fans.
He's not gonna be removed. He's not gonna be removed. He's not gonna be removed.
You feel confident in that?
My 357 Magnum is comfortable with that. End of story.
And they remove him in the Senate?
Mm-hmm.
I think it'd cause physical violence in this country that we haven't seen since the second, since the first Civil War. I think it would become the second Civil War.
I would think that there would be a strong movement. It would be very negative. Possible violence. Not that I'm condoning violence. There'll be a lot of mad Americans, possibly 70, 80 million Americans on the loose, not very happy.
Yeah, I'm not condoning violence. I'm just bringing it up on my own without being asked specifically about it constantly at the very thought that at some point Trump might not be president again. And weirdly, a whole bunch of the people that love going to these rallies and wearing red hats, when asked, what do you think about him eventually leaving office? Their thoughts are, I'm gonna grab my gun and start shooting, as Edwin was asking while that video was playing, who exactly? Who are you gonna shoot with your 357 Magnum? Are you gonna shoot Adam Schiff? Is the people who are doing the impeachment? Are you gonna shoot other Democratic politicians? Are you just gonna start shooting random liberals? Is that the idea that there's a civil war? Because after all, that's not just a few politicians versus the masses. That's two big sides. So I'm a liberal. Are you gonna shoot me? I think Trump has committed impeachable offenses. I think he should be removed from office. Are you gonna shoot me if he's removed from office? Is that the idea? These tough guys in red hats, that guy, yeah, he's gonna pull out his pistol and he's gonna fight in the second Civil War. That's what's gonna happen. The guy who would die if he tried to do 20 push-ups right there, he's gonna start taking on the masses because Donald Trump is removed for trying to bribe Ukraine into interfering in the 2020 election. I love these fake macho conservatives. That guy would be hiding at the sound of a first shot, all of them would. They go to these rallies because what they need is they want to be able to say racist, xenophobic things, but they want to feel comfortable doing it. That's why they go to a big rally and they surround themselves with tens of thousands of other people who believe the exact same thing. And if a single person even shouts out something they don't like, they want them hauled out of the room. They want the police to beat them on the way out. Yeah, real tough people, okay, when they're surrounded by people who don't disagree with them on a single thing. But honestly, this is something we return to every once in a while because this idea that if I don't get my way, I'm gonna start killing people, that is the go-to for conservatives now. You saw it when Beto O'Rourke talked about some sort of mandatory gun buyback if assault weapons were outlawed. And Ben Shapiro's response to that was, I will kill the person who comes to my house if he tries to do that. There was a thing about like, I think it was Ben Shapiro too, where he was like, if they try to teach my kids that gay marriage is okay, I will kill the person who tries to do that. This is their go-to. For all that they love to talk about how they have the ideas, they have the logic on their side, they're reasonable people. If something doesn't go their way, indeed, if anything doesn't go their way, they believe that they should be able to start shooting people. And some of them threaten it, like the guy with the pistol. Some of them, like another guy in that video, like Meghan McCain, they just say, oh, I think there will be violence. I think people will be shooting if you try to take their guns away. They don't actually ever imply that that would be a terrible thing, that that would be a horrible, immoral thing. They're just observers. And you know what? Yeah, there might be a war if Donald Trump is impeached. And the issue too is that Donald Trump has, of course, encouraged this. Other Republicans have encouraged this. So let's turn now to Louis Gohmert.
To be a one-sided, non-due process sham court. And it's about to push this country to a civil war if they were to get their wishes. And if there's one thing I don't want to see in my lifetime, I don't want to ever have participation in, it's a civil war.
Okay, but it didn't stop you from bringing it up in your address. You're not responding to a question, nobody asked you, you're worried about a civil war. You just decided, I think it'll be a civil war. I mean, I don't want that, I don't want to participate in that. And let's talk about intellectual consistency. So all of these people, regular conservative voters, Louie Gohmert, Trump himself, which we'll get to in just a second. When the Republicans were impeaching Bill Clinton, were they worried about a civil war? Were they saying, you know, I hate that this will probably leave our country racked with civil war, with conflict, but we just have to impeach him because we're worried he got a blowjob. Is that what was going on? Or is it just a threat to stop any sort of consequences whatsoever from Donald Trump for his actions? Is that a constant thing? Is that ideological consistency that they think that impeachment is never warranted because it's an overthrow of an election and because it could lead to civil war? Or is it a convenient thing that they deploy when the president they support is facing consequences for the first time in his actual life? And as I alluded to, Trump has also encouraged this. We'll get to that in one sec. This is just like a casual thing now that everyone throws around, whether you're a politician like Louie Gohmert, whether you're a pundit like Ben Shapiro, whether you're an MLB umpire like Rob Drake, who tweeted about the ongoing House impeachment inquiry saying, I will be buying an AR-15 tomorrow because if you impeach my president this way, you will have another civil war, MAGA 2020. He had to later apologize for that, because some people thought that it was inappropriate for him to be threatening to gun people down with an assault weapon if impeachment went through. Trump himself has not been, you know, sort of totally hands off here. He tweeted what Pastor Robert Jeffress said, if the Democrats are successful in removing the president from office, which they will never be, it will cause a civil war like fracture in this nation from which our country will never heal. Which is not just threatening, obviously. All of this is just, we will not follow the Constitution. Forget that whole thing about impeachment, because if you do that, we will start killing you. The idea that in 20 years, in 50 years, in 150 years, like with our first civil war, people will be looking back and saying, how dare they take out Donald Trump back then? That was when our country truly started to go downhill. If the best case scenario for Republicans at this point is that in 20 or 30 years, people pretend like Trump was never president. You are not gonna be wanting us to be looking back critically on what he did and what the Republican Party was okay with. But anyway, the issue isn't just the regular Trump supporters. It's not just the politicians that are goading them into violence. It's also the people who organize exclusively around their desire to start killing people in support of American fascism. Like the Oath Keepers who tweeted, here's the money quote from that thread. This is the truth, this is where we are. We are on the verge of a hot civil war, like in 1859, that's where we are. And the right has zero trust or respect for anything the left is doing. We see them as illegitimate too. That was just a couple of months ago. That group is desperate to start killing people. And again, I don't know who, politicians, civilians, what, the military and the cops? Are you gonna start gunning down cops? Is that what you're threatening to do? They're all really vague, but it doesn't matter who. All of that horrible, horrible stuff that they feel totally comfortable saying. And then they get people on programs like The View with Meghan McCain just, you know, maybe we gotta start shooting people. It's totally acceptable in 2019 to start threatening that if things don't go your way politically, you're gonna start killing people. And by the way, right now it's about impeachment, but you don't think that as we get closer to the general election, they're gonna be saying the same things? Like, oh no, those fake voters in California, if it doesn't go our way, we're gonna grab our guns. They were saying that in 2016, and now they love Trump even more. So anticipate that. No, this is serious. Something needs to be done to prepare for the possibility that more acts of domestic terrorism are gonna come if Trump is impeached, if God help us if he's removed, it's probably not gonna happen, but if it does, and as we get closer to the election, these people are deranged and they identify solely as gun owners. That's all they are, and they are desperate to start using those guns on humans. Thank you for watching this clip from the Damage Report. For more content from the show and access to TYT Network members only exclusives, go to tyt.com/Brook. Wait, no, it's tyt.com/John. Go to tyt.com/John to sign up.